Well, as an academic and researcher, I learned about this from mainstream media outlets and local media outlets. When you know this thing happened in Turkey, they were reporting on it. And what shocked me really was when I heard about who was behind it in the first place. That really shocked me. Well, it would be the saddest thing in my life, and one that is filled with dejection. I would be very, you know, shocked that something of that sort is happening by, especially led by an army that is supposed to be protecting the people in the first place. Because this was the Turkish Defense Force. And as a Turkish Defense Force, its number one priority is to protect the people, okay, of Turkey, to protect the Turkish people. So if the army turns against its own people, then it's like a, you know, a country at war with itself. And secondly also, what if the president was in parliament? What did they want to do? Did they want to assassinate the president of the Republic of Turkey? Is that what they were targeting? At? So, to me, it was really, you know, a great shock, if I would say. Well, it's brilliant. It's unprecedented that, you know, the Turkish people, the ordinary Turkish people, not the military, the ordinary Turkish people went out into the streets and demonstrated, telling, you know, the coup planners, the coup plotters, that no, you are not going to take power in that way, because here in Turkey we have democracy. Wait. We go for elections, and then if people elect you, then you can take power. But power will not be taken, you know, through military, you know, means in Turkey. So that scared them, because it was coming from the people. You know, it really scared them. And the Turkish people won my admiration in that they were so brave on that particular day, and they stood by their government, stood by their president, and stood for peace and democracy in Turkey. What Turkey needs to do is to make sure that this particular happening does not fizzle out. It should not be forgotten. And I'm glad that since then, every year, the Turkish, you know, government and these people commemorate this particular day as a day when democracy won. And as such, we salute the Turkish people for choosing peace over anarchy, over, you know, bloodshed. Because if they had reacted otherwise, there was going to be anarchy and bloodshed, more anarchy and bloodshed on the streets. And I also think, you know, the president, your president of the Republic, Mr. Erdogan, for allowing the rule of law to take its course. Because if he were someone like what we see elsewhere, he would have killed, you know, people or revenged or whatever. But instead, those people who committed the atrocities were rounded up and given to the courts to take, you know, their course, so that they have a day in court. This is really unprecedented. And President Erdogan did not do that. He did not kill people, you know. He could have done so. He's loyalist in the army. He could have used them to say, go after them. But he didn't. They were just rounded up, arrested, and given to the courts. As you rightly put it, FETÖ is a terrorist organization. And I agree with the Turkish government for designating them as such, because when you go out and kill people in such huge numbers, even one person, forget about the 200 plus who were killed, one person, and you are a Muslim organization, you call yourself a Muslim organization doing dawah all over the world, to me, I can't understand that. I can't. How can you call yourself a Muslim organization and you go about killing people? So they are right, the government, to designate them as a terrorist organization, and that is who they are. There is no difference between them and Al-Qaeda or ISIS, Boko Haram or Al-Shabaab of Somalia. They are the same, because they are killing people. They are into, you know, bloodshed. Is that doing that?